Good morning, dear children. Today we are going to start our next lesson, carbon and its compounds. Carbon, we know that its atomic number is 6 and it is a non-metal. And which are the allotropes of carbon? Graphite and diamond are the allotropes of carbon. And if you are taking some materials like food, medicines, clothes, etc. All these materials are based on this versatile element carbon. And we know that in earth crust, carbon contains 0.02% and in the atmosphere 0.03% as carbon dioxide. In spite of this small amount of carbon available in nature, the importance of carbon seems to be immense. So in this chapter, we are going to study carbon and its compounds. So the first topic is bonding in carbon. Okay, we know that last chapter we have discussed about ionic compounds, isn't it? So here we can see the two table. First one is ionic compound, its melting and boiling point. And the second one is carbon compounds, its boiling and melting point. Please compare these two tables. Okay, after comparing, we can conclude that the melting and boiling point of carbon compounds are less than the melting and boiling point of ionic compounds. Why it is so? We have already studied that ionic compounds have high melting and boiling point because there is a strong force of attraction between the molecules. So we have to give more energy to break this strong force of attraction, isn't it? So here the boiling point and melting point of carbon compounds less than the ionic compounds. That means there is a strong force of attraction between the molecules of this carbon compounds. Force of attraction is less than the ionic compounds. We know that carbon its atomic number is 6. So its electronic configuration is 2-4. We have already studied that ionic compounds, they attain that noble gas configuration by the transfer of electrons. So when we are comparing this carbon compounds or carbon, we know that its atomic number 6, electronic configuration is 2-4. So how will it attain its noble gas configuration 2-4? Dear children, carbon atomic number 6, electronic configuration 2-4. So to become 8 electrons in the outermost shell or a noble gas configuration, to attain that noble gas configuration, two possibilities are here. The first one, it could gain 4 electrons. It could gain 4 electrons and it will become C4 minus anion. That means if it gain that 4 electrons, it become 2A, that is C4 minus. But it is very difficult, the nucleus with the 6 protons, only 6 protons are there. So it is very difficult the nucleus with the 6 protons to hold the extra or to hold 10 electrons. If it get 4 electrons, it become 2-8. That means 10 electrons are there, but protons, number of protons only 6. So 6 protons and 10 electrons. So it is very difficult the nucleus with the 6 protons to hold the 10 electrons, extra 4 electrons. So it is not possible, the first case is not possible to gain 4 electrons. Clear? If it gain 4 electrons, become 10 electrons, total 10 electrons. So the nucleus with the 6 protons to hold this 10 electrons is very difficult. And the second condition, it could release 4 electrons and become C and release and pick up only two electrons. Two means K-shell. K-shell, if the number of electrons are two, that is stable one. But this also not possible because it is very difficult to remove four electrons from the nucleus. Need more energy to remove these four electrons from the nucleus. So it is also not possible forming these C4 cation by releasing that four electrons. So these two conditions are not possible for carbon, releasing or gaining. Okay, we could gain four electrons, but it is very difficult the nucleus with six protons to hold 10 electrons. The same way here also it is not possible, the removal of electrons are not possible because the removal need more energy. So it is also not possible leaving a C4 cation just holding with the two electrons. So the transfer of electrons is not possible in the case of carbon compounds. So carbon overcome this problem by the sharing of electrons, not transfer of electrons, by the sharing of electrons. Not just carbon, other elements are also forming or also attaining this noble gas configuration by the sharing of electrons. So carbon will share its outermost shell electrons or valence electrons with the atoms of the other carbon or the atoms of the other element. And this shared electrode belong to the outermost shells of the two and both the atoms and lead to both atom attaining this noble gas configuration. So here the bond is formed by the sharing of electron, not transfer of electron. Here bond is formed by the sharing of electrons, and that bond is called covalent bond. Okay. So from this chapter, you have to understand that carbon compounds are formed by the sharing of electrons, and that bond is called covalent bond. C-O-V-A-L-E-N-T, covalent bond. Okay. So about this covalent bond, we will study in our next classes. Okay. Thank you.